John Nicholson, Shreveport City Councilman back. Hey, Mr. John, welcome to Keel. How you doing this morning?
Hey, good morning. I'm doing fine. How's y'all?
Well, let's start with you can sort of cover them both in one question. The Monday work session, yesterday's meeting, your proposal, your idea that all liquor stores in this city should close at 9 p.m. How was that met by your fellow council people?
Well, I'll say first that it's clear from the conversations I've had with other members of the council over the past couple of days that there are not the votes to move the closed time for liquor stores up to 9 p.m., so that's not going to happen. I do think all members of the council agree that our current law, which allows liquor stores to stay open until 4 in the morning, strikes the wrong balance between convenience and public safety, and I expect that to be moved back a good bit.
So that was kind of my question, going to be my next question. Was your or is your 9 p.m. idea the opening salvo of negotiations? Did you know it didn't have a chance going into this, and you're thinking, well, I'm just going to start at 9 and we'll see what we can work out? Is that sort of how you're looking at this?
I wouldn't say that I knew that we wouldn't get it done at 9 p.m., but on the council, we're always negotiating. That's what democracy is all about. So I certainly recognize the possibility that the time would not be 9 p.m.
Could this idea to close liquor stores across the city at 9 p.m. somehow be related to the new liquor store in your district at Kings and Gilbert, that the compromise was reached that it will have to close to be opened at 9 p.m.?
Well, look, it's related in this respect. That hearing on the special use permit for the liquor store at Gilbert and Kings, which, as you know, passed with a restriction that the liquor store will have to close at 9 p.m., caused me to look at the citywide standard. The default closing time for all liquor stores or stores where the primary commodity sold is alcohol. And I saw that it was 4 p.m. and thought, well, that doesn't seem reasonable to me.
You mean 4 a.m., 4 a.m., right?
Yes, 4 a.m. did not seem reasonable to me. And so that's how we started the conversation.
Was it in anyone's mind, including yours, prior to the Kings and Gilbert controversy, that liquor store hours were a problem?
I will say for myself that I have always thought that 4 a.m. Was not a reasonable time for liquor stores to close as soon as I became aware of that, which was, you know, the past several weeks.
Is this going to go to the safety committee, as I heard you mention yesterday, at all? What's going to happen with it now?
It has been referred yesterday by motion to the public safety committee. I expect that we'll have a conversation in which different stakeholders and members of the public can express their opinions about this, and we'll see what happens. I do want to say this. You know, nationally, almost 90,000 people die from alcohol abuse. Almost 30% of all fatal car accidents are related to alcohol. The council's job is to strike the right balance between convenience and public safety, and I just want to help us do that by initiating this conversation.
John, let me ask you this, and a lot of people are saying this. Right down the street from Kings and Gilbert is Brookshire's, where I can buy a six-pack of beer, I can buy a bottle of wine as late as Brookshire's is open. Is that not fair to liquor stores who you're asking to close at an earlier time than grocery stores?
You cannot buy hard liquor at that Brookshire's, and that's really what I'm focused on with this legislation. Is it fair? I mean, as I've said in a recent interview, I want businesses of all kinds to be successful in the city, but my primary concern is the impact that liquor stores have on the communities in which they're located.
I do not know how many package stores, liquor stores, there are inside the Shreveport city limits. You may. What percentage of the liquor stores do you know that are staying open until that 4 a.m. hour right now, or are most closing 10, 11, midnight?
Most are closing by midnight, to my knowledge. I'm not aware of any that stay open until 4 a.m.
Are you anticipating a lawsuit by Bernie Woods, who's opening that liquor store at Kings and Gilbert, to challenge that earlier closing time? And was your effort kind of to stave that off?
Well, first, there's a pending lawsuit that was filed years before Mr. Woods' store came to the council recently. And to my understanding, that lawsuit continues. No, my purpose in introducing this legislation was not to stave off a lawsuit. And I do think that the 9 p.m. restriction that was imposed on Mr. Wood's store is reasonable and appropriate, given that it is immediately adjacent to a private residence, regardless of the outcome of this legislation concerning citywide closing.
But the Thrifty on Uri is immediately adjacent to residences, and they can stay open way later. Have you put him at a disadvantage with the hours you've imposed on him?
Well, I personally think 9 p.m. would be a reasonable time for liquor stores to close citywide. And so if the decision were mine alone, that is what would happen. I don't think we're putting Mr. Woods at an unfair disadvantage. I think he'll do just fine if he opens the store with the restrictions that have been imposed.
John, we're talking to Councilman John Nicholson. Let me ask you, yesterday your comments were, they hit a nerve for me because you went and you addressed some of the many liquor stores that are approved, and we haven't really talked about this yet today, so let me go there. The many liquor stores over the years that have been approved in poorer neighborhoods that would have never been allowed in my neighborhood or your neighborhood. Why have we been doing that, and how do we stop that without your ordinance? Is there another way?
Well, my ordinance, the ordinance I proposed, is the first idea that I've had. I know that Councilwoman Buller is working with the MPC and other members of city staff to come up with some changes to the zoning rules for liquor stores. Perhaps that won't be part of the solution. But yeah, I mean, that strikes a nerve with me as well, Aaron. As I said yesterday during the council meeting, 25 years ago as a kid riding down Line Avenue with my parents from South Shreveport to the center of town, it passed by stores selling liquor and alcohol at all hours of the night. And even as a young adolescent, I recognized that wasn't right. When Outback Steakhouse 20 years ago wanted to put a very nice restaurant right outside my parents' neighborhood, the neighborhood went to war to prevent it from doing so because it was going to have a bar, and they won. And it's just not right or fair that wealthy neighborhoods that have the resources to hire lawyers and marshal other resources don't get liquor stores put in the neighborhoods while other folks do. And I want that to change.
Mr. John, you are by nature a conservative-leaning man. Do you see is there a contradiction in your own ideologies between what you are ideologically speaking, instinctively believing in, and what some might call government overreach?
Look, I do not think that it is in any way inconsistent with conservative principles to impose reasonable regulations on alcohol because of the harms that we all know were associated with it. And so, I don't think it's inconsistent in any way.
But aren't the harms, not to get way off track, aren't the harms the same before 9 p.m. as after?
I'll say this. I think if you are going to the liquor store in the middle of the night to buy liquor rather than waiting until the next day, that perhaps you've got an issue with alcohol that you need to address. And you're doing that, and consuming alcohol can cause harm that extends far beyond you, the drinker.